Right, thank you, Grace and Adam, for taking the time to meet up with me today. Really appreciate it. So I have a few questions.
How was your life before you became Muslim?
I feel I'm so lost. I just feel that I don't have any purpose in my life. Every day I just do what everyone is doing. Just wake up, go to work, and then go home, and that's it. Something is missing. Something very big thing in my life is missing. I just couldn't find the answer until I get to know about Islam.
Assalamualaikum. Before I become Muslim, actually I was born in a Catholic family, so I was very active in the church. So I grew up in the church. I have the spiritual part of that. However, being a Christian, there was one burning question which is, how can Jesus be God when he's a human being?
How did you discover Islam?
I actually met up with my client for the first time, and then when he passed me his name card, his name is Brian Muhammad. After the meeting, I asked him a question like, so do you actually stop eating pork and drink alcohol and things like that? Then he asked me that, why would you like to go? Then I said that, I think because normally people became Muslim because of marriage. He was laughing, and then he showed me the wife pictures, and then I look at the wife picture and like, your wife does not look Malay. And then he told me that my wife is a Chinese, and I'm like, okay, how can that be? So both of us embrace Islam. So I'm like, you know, if my jaw can drop to the floor, it will drop to the floor. It's like, you must be a crazy couple, and I think everyone is thinking both of us are crazy couple nowadays. And they know that we are both embrace Islam by our own views. He da'wah to me, he talked to me about Tawhid, in one God, which actually this is the question that I've been asking throughout my life. As a Taoist myself, we pray to many, many different idols, except Allah, I would say. When I learn more about the Creator, which is Allah, and I know that this is something that I should really learn more about.
How do you learn more about Islam from that one?
He actually invited me to attend classes at Al Qadim. When I go to Al Qadim, my intention is to find fault. Seriously, I don't think that Islam should be the one, you know. When I go to Al Qadim, I have a mission that I want to make Ustaz life difficult. So I ask a lot of questions, you know, like why can I touch a dog, why the man can marry four wives. But whenever Ustaz explained to me all these things, the answers seriously amazed me. I just like, oh, this is something that really from God. It cannot be from a human. The more I ask, the more I fight about it, the more I feel that I'm nearer to the truth. Yeah. So after 3 months, I think, in this struggle, I actually know that I'm already a Muslim in my heart. And after 6 months, then I said my shahada.
For me, it was at work that there was a project that we had to do this project in 24 hours. So I was assigned as the night shift, the technical representative. And I was talking to the night shift of the operation representative. So we were talking during break. So I was asking him about Islam, because I used to, you know, discuss religion with others so that, you know, I can introduce Christianity to others. So as I was talking to these colleagues of mine, I asked him about Islam. So I asked him a lot of questions. And then I remember he couldn't give me answers. So I said, okay, now I got him, you know. Then he said, but he didn't give up on me. He told me, you ask very good questions, but I don't know the answer. But what I can tell you is, tomorrow, if you don't mind, I can bring you some CDs. So you can watch the CD and find answers yourself. So I said, okay, fine. So then come tomorrow. I went to see him, you know, with confidence. And so where's the CD? Where's the CD you were talking about? You know, and then he So it's not like he was the one who came to me. So I went to see him. Said, where was the seat? Give me the seat. So he said, oh, okay. He did find bring along the CDs, and he gave it to me. So as I took the CD, I found out, hey, this is Ahmad Didat, the debate between Ahmad Didat and Pastor. And the title of the debate was Jesus Crucified. So I went back after the project is finished. So I went back to my home. I start watching the CD. The whole debate was very interesting. So I was, after watching the whole debate, I got very angry. I asked myself, how can a Muslim stand in front of everyone using Bible to convince the Christians that Jesus were not crucified? He did not even use the Quran, he was using the Bible. I got even more anxious. I said, how can all this while, the religion that I have embraced and really believed in, how come now there are so many loopholes? So I start digging into more, and I found out that so Jesus even mentioned about the coming of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I said, how can that be? You know? And I also found another book that written by a revert also. Now he become a scholar. So he wrote the book. There was two volumes of book that he actually looked at all the spiritual books, all the so-called holy scriptures in all other religions, the Buddhism, the Hinduism, all their books. He actually found out each of the scriptures, all of the major religions, the scriptures actually mentioned the coming of Muhammad. I bought the book and I read the book, and I was even more convinced that Muhammad must be the final messenger. Finally struck me, and I said, you know, I finally found myself being cornered. And I said, if everyone else is talking about him, meaning the coming of the last messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he also confirmed all these other prophets has, you know, exist before, then it answered my burning question. And Jesus was never God. He was just a human being. He was the messenger of Allah.
So how do you guys met?
I met him on the day I say my shahada.
How long have you guys been married?
Coming 6.
6 years. 6 years. Okay. How is it being married, living with each other as reverts all this while? How does it feel?
It's hard. I think being a couple is just like any other couples. It's the same. The best part is we know what we want in our life. We know the path that we want for our children, for ourselves, and we always support each other in doing the things for the sake of our life, for dunya and akhirah.
What's your favorite part in Ramadan?
For me, it's like a yearly reminder. You will actually wanted to be closer to Allah, and you will strive to be a better person. And you know, it could be the last Ramadan for ourselves.
In the month of Ramadan, I get more fresh air, because Muslims don't smoke during the daytime. Alhamdulillah. Can you imagine if after Ramadan all the Muslims quit smoking? Remember, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has never started something good and leave it after that. He would always continue. So as a Muslim, it is a reminder for all of us. If we stop smoking in the month of Ramadan, we should stop. If you stop picking up the book of Allah in the month of Ramadan, after that, continue.
Thank you for sharing your experience. Really appreciate it. Thank you so much.